Did you know that according to a UNICEF report of 2018, the Indian education system is one of the largest in the world with more than 250 million children and 1.5 million schools? Thanks to funding and development, the numbers are rising every day. But what is that one word that is almost synonymous with school and children? Well, you got it right. Exams. Raise your hands if you get the nervous tics before exams. We all do. But for some, it doesn't end well. Infamously known as exam fever, this is a very common phenomenon among students. A little stress and fear before an examination pushes students to buckle up and ace it. But things start to get out of hand when the fear slowly turns into a phobia, with psychological, social, emotional, and physiological effects. Exam phobia hasn't even spared greats like Albert Einstein. The only thing that Winston Churchill managed to write on his answer sheet was his name. Shocked? Well, there's more in store for you. So where did examinations come from? The concept of examinations dates back to 605 AD, when ancient China became the first country in the world to implement a nationwide standardized test for government jobs. Today, a test or examination is an assessment of one's knowledge, skill, or competency. But sadly, it is all turned into a big competition. This phobia inevitably leads to stress, paving way for anxiety and depression to seep in anytime before, during, or even after the exam, which ultimately results in poor performance. Exam phobia is often triggered by low motivation levels, high expectation from others, tough competition from other students, and lack of preparation. So what are some of the ways to deal with this? Before an exam, identify the time of the day when you can concentrate the most. Some prefer early morning, while others prefer night time. Whichever time you choose, just remember to give enough time to your brain to rest and process all that you studied. It's like giving your brain time to digest the information you fed it. Solve past question papers and time yourself while doing so. This helps in time management during the actual exam. Talk to someone if the stress gets too much to take. It is important to relax right before the exam, because the more you stress and pressurize your brain, the more you tend to forget things. Stay away from the students who give out that crazy nervous energy before exams. You know, with all the nail biting and last minute revisions. While studying, go point by point. Keep checking the index as you go through. Listening to concentration-boosting music really helps in calming the mind down. Drink hot chocolate if you want to, or go out and play for a while. Do whatever makes you happy. During an exam, take deep breaths before going through the question paper. Comb through it thoroughly and tick the ones that will need more time to answer. Power through the known questions first, leaving space and time to circle back to the difficult ones. Once you are done submitting the answer sheet, do not immediately start with the autopsy. Avoid asking everyone, "Hey, how was your exam?" Remember, they might be just as stressed as you are. So head home and relax. If you fare well, good for you. But if you don't, do not take failure as a loss. You are simply getting a second chance to come back again, only stronger next time. Students constantly feel that they will either forget their answers or will not be able to write anything. A small amount of anxiety actually helps the brain function, helping students memorize what they had studied. But when this minimal level is crossed, the negative effects start outweighing the good. Students lose focus, some crumble under pressure, while some simply choose to run away from exams. For them, not appearing is a better option than failing. Parents and teachers can play a big role in helping students overcome exam phobia. Regular one-on-one interactions help in understanding what a child is going through. It not only helps parents keep track of their child's growth, but also makes the child feel that they have someone to talk to. Most examophobics complain of not having a clear understanding of a particular subject as their cause of anxiety. Here, a teacher can comfort them by being available for clearing their doubts. Proper preparation with in-depth and detailed studying groups with friends and teachers can help keep the fear of exams away. A balanced diet with meditation, ample sleep and sufficient breaks between lessons will surely help in keeping anxiety at bay. You have got it, champ! See you again on Know It All. Till then, keep playing the quiz on Mind Wars.